That's why the NGO, there's two forms of NGOs. One, they go on their own without informing the Ministry of Health. They just go on their own, they do their activities. But our fear is that they will get infected, especially if the NGOs do not have experience in terms of infection control, etc. So their intention is good, but then we also need to protect the NGOs. You look into our frontliners, they also get infected. So what more NGOs coming to the ground? So we also have a few NGOs already form a cluster coming back from Sabah, already have a new cluster in Selangor, for example. And a few of our staff also got infected. So we advise them, the first is that if they want to come in to participate, join the Ministry of Health, so we will give them the training, the basic training in terms of infection control and etc. Second, in terms of coordination, where to go, what to do and etc. So I think there are a lot of things that we can do together, avoid duplication and complement each other. So rather than duplicate the services at the ground level.